Hi friends, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and I'm here with a video on public demand. Yes guys, on public demand, because I think that from the day I've started my website and this YouTube channel, the most frequently asked question that I have got from students is, ma'am, which book should we refer for UGC NET? And ma'am, how should we read these guidebooks? Because irrespective of the fact that I've mentioned the name of books in so many of my videos, I have circulated these messages on social media, a lot of students are still finding it difficult to understand that how they should approach a guidebook. So I thought of making a separate video dealing specifically with this question, so that finally aap sabhi ke dukh ka nivaran ho. We are already troubled with the coronavirus, so I think that let me just make your life a bit more easy by telling you exactly the methodology in which you should read any guidebook. Now, the very first thing that you must remember is to do selective reading. What I meant by selective reading, you can choose any guidebook of your choice. There's no foundation on that. There's no good book or bad book. It is just a book. Okay, you can choose any book according to your preference. But then a smart student knows how to study from that particular book. What mostly students do is that they're going to memorize the entire book and then go to the question paper and try to solve it. And even after memorizing the book, they are going to find that there are innumerable questions that they are not able to answer. So that's where you have to break the chain and you have to reverse the process. Rather than memorizing the book and then solving the question paper, you have to first solve the question paper, see what kind of questions are being asked, and only study those topics from the guidebook. This is how this preparation should be done. There's a very, very beautiful line that I want you to drill in your brain. And the line says that activity without direction is just change. Activity with direction is progress. If you want to make progress in your UGC NET preparation, you have to do work, but with a direction. अगर आप गलत डायरेक्शन में काम करते जाएंगे, सिर्फ चेंज होगा, प्रोग्रेस नहीं होगी. सो एक्टिविटी विथ डायरेक्शन इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड दैट इज़ वेयर आई कम टू द पॉइंट दैट यू हैव टू बी वेरी सेलेक्टिव इन योर रीडिंग. वेन एवर यू आर रीडिंग समथिंग, आस्क योर सेल्फ, इज इट रेलिवेंट. A week earlier, I made a video, okay, on UGC NET Paper 1 Teaching Aptitude. Now, I've started this video series just for you guys so that I can tell you what exactly you have to learn from a textbook or a guidebook of UGC NET Paper 1. Because I don't want you to waste your time and energy. Even in my online course, that's what I keep on doing. I tell students that ye jo main bata rahi hu, bas itna hi padhna hai, because these are the questions which have been asked from this topic. If a topic is irrelevant, kyun pad rahe ho? Already bahut bada syllabus hai. So in that video, if you have watched my paper 1 video on teaching aptitude, you must have seen that I have discussed concept of teaching. That's the first subtopic under teaching aptitude. And in that topic, I've mentioned that aaj tak is topic se koi question nahi aaya hai. Concept of teaching introductory topic hai, isse kabhi koi question nahi poochte hain. Okay, so you know that acha, agar guidebook mein concept of teaching pe 10 pages hai, to mujhe inhe yaad nahi karna, because question hi nahi aa raha. This will only happen when you first go to the question paper and then try to look at the guidebook. So first important point, put in your brain, do selective reading. अब आप बोलेंगे कि चलिए मैम, ये तो पता चल गया कि कैसे पढ़ना है, लेकिन कौन सी किताब से पढ़ना है ये तो बताइए. नाउ दैट आई एम डीलिंग विथ UGC NET इन जनरल, सो आई के नॉट टॉक अबाउट द बेस्ट बुक्स इन ईच ऑफ दी सब्जेक्ट पेपर्स, बिकॉज आई हैव एन एक्सपर्टीज इन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो द बेस्ट बुक्स फॉर लिटरेचर, यू कैन व्हाट्सएप ऑन द नंबर डिस्प्ले देयर, सो दैट माई टीम कैन सेंड यू द बुक लिस्ट. बट फॉर एवरी वन इन जनरल, आई हैव गॉट फ्यू थिंग्स टू टेल यू. नंबर वन, make sure that the language of book is very easy. For example, a person who has done BSc and for the first time is sitting for UGC NET English Literature, he has just enrolled in Masters in Literature, he is not going to understand the book David Deci's. Why? Because the language is tough and it is a very advanced level book. So the first thing, whenever you are deciding on which book to buy, make sure that you read a few chapters and then see if you're able to understand the language. लैंग्वेज समझ नहीं आई तो बहुत तोप किताब पढ़ने से कुछ नहीं होगा, क्योंकि दिमाग में कुछ नहीं घुसेगा. सेकेंड थिंग, whenever you are looking at a book, see आपका लेवल कहाँ है और बुक का लेवल क्या है. अगर बुक एडवांस लेवल की है और आपका बेसिक से हिले हुए हैं, तो एडवांस लेवल की बुक कैसे समझ आएगी. सो यू हैव टू मैच दैट. अगर आपने एक बेसिक लेवल की बुक पढ़ ली, नाउ यू आर गुड विद बेसिक्स, यू वॉन्ट टू मूव टू अनदर लेवल, देन रीड समथिंग विच इज मोर डिफिकल्ट. सो इन बुक सेलेक्शन कीप दीज थिंग्स इन माइंड. ये एक बहुत बड़ा मिथ है दैट मैम विच इज द बुक टू क्वालिफाई नेट. ऐसी कौन सी किताब है जिससे सारे क्वेश्चन आते हैं. अरे इट्स अ कॉम्पिटिटिव एग्जाम गाइज, अंडरस्टैंड. अगर इतना ही ईजी होता कि एक किताब को मगअप करके आप निकाल पाते तो एवरीबडी वुड हैव नेल्ड इट. नो इट्स नॉट ईजी. The reason is that there is no the book. It is just a book. It is a part of your preparation. वही से questions नहीं आएंगे. कोई भी writer claim नहीं कर सकता कि मेरी book में से ही questions आएंगे. No. So make sure that you don't put all your energy in just getting that perfect book which is going to get you all the marks. No. There's a very great saying which I love, that don't miss the forest just for trees. आप trees को देखने में इतना ज़्यादा परेशान हो कि आप forest को नहीं देख पा रहे, तो क्या मतलब है. Always look at the overall goal. Your overall goal is to clear net. Now book is just a part of that process of clearing net. It is not the only way to clear net. Okay, and the third and the most important thing that you must remember when it comes to selecting that book, make sure that the book is authentic. It has got correct information. Meri team बहुत सारी ये जो बुक्स हैं इनको स्टडी करती रहती है, सो दैट वी कैन गिव द बेस्ट बुक्स टू आवर स्टूडेंट्स. एंड अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम माय टीम हैज़ टोल्ड मी दैट इतने बेसिक क्वेश्चंस गलत है इस बुक में, इतने बेसिक फैक्ट्स गलत है कई बुक्स में, दैट इट बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट दैट बुक इन विच एवरीथिंग इज ऑथेंटिक. सो जब भी आप कोई बुक पढ़ रहे हैं, मेक श्योर दैट यू सी वेदर द इंफॉर्मेशन गिवन देयर इज ऑथेंटिक और नॉट. गाइड बुक्स में ये बहुत बड़ा पंगा है. इन मोस्ट ऑफ द गाइड books you'll find irrelevant information plus inauthentic information. The date of the writer would be wrong, or if you're reading at some fact or you're solving some mock test questions which are there in the book, you will find majority of the answers are wrong. Now aap sahi kar rahe hain but answer kuch aur show kar raha hai, to you will question your own preparation. So make sure in cheezon ka aap dhyan rakhe. Jahan bhi book mein koi fact hai jo aapko lag raha hai galat hai, गूगल का सहारा लीजिए. गो टू सम ग्रेट वेबसाइट्स लाइक ब्रिटानिका, विकीपीडिया, रीचेक द फैक्ट्स एंड देन मेक द करेक्शन इन द बुक इटसेल्फ, सो दैट यू डोंट गेट ट्रैप्ड इन द रॉन्ग इन्फॉर्मेशन. एंड फाइनली बिफोर आई एंड दिस वीडियो, आई एम गोइंग टू आंसर द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, हाउ टू मेक नोट्स फ्रॉम दीज गाइड बुक्स. वेरी सिंपल टिप्स आई वुड लाइक टू गिव. नंबर वन, stop being a photocopy machine. We already have some great photocopy machines in the world, so you don't need to do that task. Most of the students are going to read the book and write down each and everything which is written, so photocopy ban jati hai. This is not how notes has to be prepared. Now what's the right manner? Just think about a situation. You have a younger brother who is in class 7th. Now this younger brother of yours has to give a test tomorrow. He has not yet studied anything, and the test is on unit 1, teaching aptitude, for example. Now how are you going to teach that kid teaching aptitude in just one day? आप कौन कौन से पॉइंट्स उसको बताएंगे और किस तरीके से फटाफट फटाफट उसको रिविजन करवाएंगे. That is exactly how you need to make notes. This is called sibling method. Now what is sibling method? Basically, आपको उस book में से सिर्फ वही points लिखने हैं जो आपके हिसाब से examiner definitely पूछ सकता है, और सिर्फ वही चीज़ें pointers में लिखनी है जो आपको revision के time काम आएगी. उसके अलावा जितनी भी irrelevant information है, skip everything. आपका अगर एक page में 300 words हैं, तो आपके notes में सिर्फ 10% आना चाहिए, दैट इज 30 वर्ड्स. एक पेज के 300 वर्ड्स में से आपको सिर्फ 30 वर्ड अपनी नोटबुक में लिखने हैं, दैट्स इट. इतना सेलेक्टिव होना पड़ेगा, नहीं तो कोर्स कंप्लीट हो भी गया तो आप रिवाइज नहीं कर पाएंगे. सो मेक श्योर दैट यू गो बैक टू दिस वीडियो अगेन एंड वॉच इट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गेट क्लैरिटी ऑन हाउ यू शुड यूज गाइड बुक्स फॉर UGC नेट प्रिपरेशन. आई थिंक आई हैव ट्राइड टू डू जस्टिस टू दिस टॉपिक एंड टू दिस question that has been asked by hundreds and thousands of students. So with that note, I would like to take your leave, but before that, please make sure that you hit the subscribe button. Also, if you want to look at the previous year question papers, they are available free of cost on my website arpitakarwa.com. along with that, we are running some amazing extraordinary courses for UGC NET English Literature, so make sure you visit our website and get all the details, demo material. Plus, if you have not yet followed us on social media, I think the time is right now, because we are going to update you about all the important UGC NET notification and exam date changes through social media. So with that note, I am going to take your leave. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.